Hi students! Sveiki studenti! I am a Latvian and I teach Latvian to English speakers. And today I'm going to respond to letters that you wrote to me. And specifically I'm going to respond to two questions about how to learn Latvian, how to start learning Latvian, and also how to learn Latvian to the level so that you can actually get a job in Latvia. Those questions were asked to me while I was visiting Latvia, so I couldn't answer really properly because I didn't have much time to think about it. But now I think I really owe these answers to you, my listeners and my followers. So first thing about what I think, how you should start learning the Latvian. And I think it's really important to start by learning the Latvian sounds, to be able to write small dictations. And that's exactly why I have a course, Sounds and Writing. But this is not just my idea. On July the 3rd, when I was in Latvia, I heard a program on Latvian public radio number 1, where three people were interviewed. And they were not Latvian people, but they were able to speak Latvian fluently and to give interviews on the national radio. One of them was a Japanese person, his name was Daiki. And the other one was a Brazilian woman, her name was Solange. And the third person was an Estonian guy whose name was Madis. They all had learned Latvian in different ways. Madis had come to Latvia as an exchange student and he was thrown in the university and he was listening to the lectures and he couldn't understand a thing. So he was actually forced to learn Latvian because he had only 1 year to study and he had to study difficult subjects. So he managed that and he actually learned Latvian. The Brazilian woman, Solange, married a Latvian and she had lived with her husband somewhere else before they moved to Latvia. She had a Latvian book that she used to study Latvian, but when she came to Latvia, she actually got a job without knowing Latvian that well, not knowing it really. She probably got that job because she knew other languages, but an interesting thing that she told to the listeners was that sometimes when there was nobody else in the office and the telephone rang, she picked up the phone and she tried to write down what that person was saying phonetically without understanding it. And then she would show that text to somebody else, to a Latvian, her husband often, and they were trying to figure out what that person had said so that she could deliver that message to her boss. Therefore, I think it's very important to actually know how to write in Latvian properly, because if you write down what you hear in your language, and I teach English speakers, so if you write down the way you would write down things in English, no Latvian would understand it. So you've got to learn to write in Latvian. And thirdly, the Japanese guy, Daiki, is a linguist and he studied Latvian independently because he was interested in the Latvian language. So he had higher standards for himself. And when he was asked what was the point at which he thought he knew Latvian well, he said it was after 3 years. As opposed to Solange, the Brazilian woman who said that she started speaking Latvian really quickly in the second year, but that would be because these people had different standards. Solange said, and also Madis agreed with her, that it is important to speak even if you can't speak correctly. It is important to not be shy to speak Latvian, because you're gonna learn from your own mistakes. That's the way to learn. And I agree, that's the way to learn. Daiki also said that what he does and what he recommends is to read Latvian aloud every day, even if only for 15 minutes, because that way you are practicing to pronounce Latvian sounds, and also you are practicing reading in Latvian. So how do Latvians write down things differently than English people or in the English language? Well, let's take the very famous tongue twister in English, and I'm going to only take a part of it. She sells seashells by the seashore. So first of all, I have to tell you that there is no the sound in Latvian. So sometimes when a Latvian speaks English, he or she cannot pronounce the sound, and they would say either ze or de, kind of like French people sometimes do. And there is also no Y letter in Latvian, which we have in the word by the seashore. But what we hear, we Latvians, what we hear in this word is the diphthong I, which consists of two vowels, Latvian vowels A and I, and together they are pronounced as I. So now you know how to write down the word by. It will be B-A-I, as you would say it in English. Next, there are special characters in Latvian. For instance, if you see like a check above a consonant, for instance, if I wrote a word like this, she, that would be the sh sound, like in the word she, or shower, or shake. But when you see a little dash above a vowel, that means the vowel needs to be pronounced long, like in the same word she. Because if you didn't have that lengthening sign above that vowel, if you had a period above it like this, then a Latvian would read it as she, but you want them to read it as she. Do you notice the difference? One more thing. We write the shells and cells with double L, but in Latvian, when you write it with double L, you actually hear it longer. It would be pronounced like this, cells, shells. So if I were to transcribe the tongue twister, she sells seashells by the seashore, in Latvian, it would look like this. So these are the skills that I'm teaching in my course, Sounds and Writing. And that would be my answer to that question. And my answer to the other question, what level of Latvian you need to have before you can land a job in Latvian, I would say don't worry about it. Latvians would not ask you to have a certificate before they would give you a job, because there are certain jobs where you don't need to know Latvian that well. I don't think you should wait before trying to apply for the job. Just go for it and learn on the way to it. And learn the language day by day, if only 15 minutes reading aloud. By the way, I will give you the transcript of the sentence, she sells seashells by the seashore in Latvian, if you want it. So you only have to click the link in the description of this video. In my next video, I'll probably tell you how to proceed with learning the Latvian. But now I'll say, atā, bye-bye, till the next time.